Now, many of you are, as you mentioned at the start, in first, second, and third year. Okay, this is not for graduates, but those who are in first, second, and third year, guys, take your Indian exam seriously. Because believe me, the National Medical Commission has been established on 25th September 2020, and this is a historic decision. NMC is here to stay and bringing lots of changes. And one and the biggest change is this, that you guys have to appear the license exam. So unlike your seniors, you cannot practice without clearing the national exit examination. Earlier, students who are studying abroad only had to appear training exam. Students in government or private institutions in India who just wanted to practice as an MBBS did not have to appear any exams. Those seeking PG had to appear NEET PG. But now everyone from 2017 batch onwards needed to write the next exam. So a kind request or a sincere request to each one of you, gear up. The things are not as same as what it were for your seniors. You need to start thinking about India as well as global right from first year. I will show you the roadmap and I'm sure your seniors will agree that the right time to start is as early as first year. So now with this clarity, let us understand all the different global options, pros and cons, challenges, and which are the there what we could do, all right? So as I told you, any country abroad, whether you want to do PG, whether you want to settle, or you want a license, you have to give the license exam. So US has an exam called as USMLE, UK has an exam called as PLAB, India has NEXT, Canada has Medical Council of Canada evaluation exam, Australia has AMC, New Zealand has NZREX, Germany has FSP, KSP, and the Gulf countries, the Middle East, each of the Emirates have different exams like MOH for Saudi Arabia, Dubai Health Authority, Health Authority of Abu Dhabi. So every country has their own license exam for the registration of the medical board of that country. Obviously, the next question which students have, sir, how difficult the exam is? So by far the most difficult exam globally is the United States medical license exam. Why? Because it is as real to your actual clinical scenario as it could be. So it is always said that if you prepare for USMLE, you will be ready for any exam globally by default. Okay, PLAB is of a medium level because it is actually to do with your linguistic abilities. I mean, in fact, PLAB will be replaced by an exam called as UKMLA few years from now. It was scheduled for 2020, but thanks to COVID, things have been messed in UK right now. India, of course, next is going to be a difficult exam because unfortunately, due to mismatch of number of applicants and the seats, Indian systems are more to reject people rather than select. So that's how it is. Canadian exams are of medium level, Australian medium, New Zealand medium, German exams are easy. And so are Gulf country exams easy for Indian students. Okay, quota system. Okay, this is very important. A lot of times when you aspire to do things abroad, you need to understand that it's not that easy. Okay, there is a stringent quota involved in this process. So US for residency programs or PG programs, there are no quota systems whatsoever applicable. UK very much, in fact, Britishers taught India, Canada, Australia, every colony which they ruled, British colonies once upon a time, they taught the quota system. Germany, of course, no quota system. And of course, in Gulf countries, there is nothing called as quota. Let's talk about the PG seats. As I told you at the start, there are some countries where you can do PG. There are some countries where you can settle. So to do PG, US has 34,000 seats, UK has 15,000, India around 30,000. Seats are increasing year on year. Canada 2000, Australia 5000, New Zealand 500, Germany 5000, Gulf countries 500. Now, everybody has this concern in mind with regards to visa. Now, to do post-graduation and the work visa required for that, the issues are the least in America. The post-graduation work visa rejection rate is less than 0.1%. UK, this is the highest globally, the visa rejection rate, because absolutely no coordination between the UK BA and NHS. Okay, you can Google it out and you'll realize these are two independent agencies, the health NHS and immigration authority UK BA. Absolutely no coordination and hence high rejection rate. India, of course, there is no issues. Canada, very low issues. Australia, low issues. New Zealand, low issues. Germany, of course, there are no problems and no problems in the Gulf countries. All right, to settle. All right, now Where can you settle? You can settle after completing PG from USA in America. All right. You cannot settle in America if you have not done your PG from America. Okay. So please, every country has a different regulation to settle. So you can settle in America only if you have done PG from America. You cannot settle in UK irrespective. And I will prove it to you what are the problems. There are grave problems, and you will realize that during the course of this course, you know, the session. When we say settle in India, usually what I mean is that the long process of UG, PG and Super PG and the challenges involved in it, okay? A lot of times if you don't get a seat in a government college, you pay crores of rupees in private college. So the process is long. It takes a lot of time, money. A lot of time people are in grave debts. I know of a lot of students who have got jobs of 1 or 2 lakhs, but they are paying EMIs equally just to square off their PG loans. So it's not a great situation if you get into a private college PG in India, okay? But if you get a PG seat, okay, in a government college in India, and if you have done a PG from India, okay, if you have done a PG from India or America, you can definitely settle in Canada, Australia, New Zealand, or the Gulf countries. So all of these countries do not have adequate seats available to do PG. Okay. However, they definitely have seats where you can settle. Okay. So meaning there is something called as a specialist pathway. If you are already a PG from India or any country abroad which is recognized in that country. So in this case, it is America. So if you are a PG from India or America, you definitely can settle in any of these countries, provided you appear MECI for Canada, AMC for Australia, New Zealand for NZRES for New Zealand, and apply via a specialist pathway and parallelly file for your immigration. Okay, we'll talk much in detail about that, but broadly, yes, you can settle in these countries. Germany is a very unique option. Now, who considers the German option? Okay, let us understand that properly. Germany, the entire language of training is in German language. So it's a one-way route. You cannot come back and work in India. So the German degrees are recognized in Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. So who actually considers this option? This option is considered by students who have tried NEET PG for at least 3 to 4 times, have given up on India, do not have stamina or final efforts, or maybe whatever, you are already 10-year-old graduate and do not have that mental stamina to write the USMLE and are very clear that they do not want to come back to India. Those students consider Germany option because it's a one-way route. The entry point is not that difficult, but the condition is you can succeed in the German healthcare system provided you can master the German language. So if you are good at German language, you can definitely succeed in that system. That's the only condition. All right. And in the Gulf countries, I told her, if you have a PG from India or US, you can very well settle. Now, let us talk about the disadvantages of each and every country. US, it's a long process, requires hard work, it requires patience. Lot of time people want shortcut. No, American process is a long route, but end of the day, you are getting immensely benefited from it. People don't have patience, so unfortunately, they are wanting quick results. So you can always get a quick result if you do get a private seat from India, okay? But otherwise, US is a great option, and I'm sure all of you might be aware, for those who are not, the idea, Indian private medical colleges, you know, you have tuition fees of 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs, 50 lakhs, you know, per year. The reason US is so popular is because in America, there is no tuition fee to do post-graduation. The post-graduation is absolutely free of cost, okay? So those who are thinking, is it 35 lakhs, 50 lakhs, 1 crore? No, it is zero. And that is why US is a very, very popular destination. In America, you don't pay any tuition fee to do PG. Okay. But yes, that is correct. It's a long process. So it is tiresome. You know, people don't like it like the other countries. Okay. Unlike India for that matter. So that is the only disadvantages which I can tell you right now for the American process. Let's talk about the disadvantages of the UK system. The problems with UK are never ending. First of all, concerns are there with regards to a differential tax system. for international students, racism is there, issues of office jobs. This thing called the British Association of Physicians of Indian Origin. They have complained of the issues which the UK physicians face. Because, you know, the concerns, competition, quota, high debt, preferred branches not available. So these are typical issues when it comes to India. So we were talking about the disadvantages of each of these countries. So American process is long. It takes a lot of time, money. It's basically very, the exams are difficult. People calculate that initial investment in the American process is around 20-25 lakhs. But, you know, if we see on the hindsight, it is 1/5 of the cost to buy a private seat in India. Okay. Because if you get a PG seat in America, you will recover that money the first year. But yes, it is an expensive process. It's a long process and it's a career decision. So you cannot just socially, a lot of people want to complete things at one particular age. I tell them, do not consider US. If you want everything in life at the age of 21, 22, best thing is to buy a private seat. In terms of UK, the problems are with regards to the taxation, the visa policies, racism. British Medical Journal has articles from Indian doctors talking about the racism which they are facing, back office jobs and other issues. How many of you have heard about some recent announcement happening in UK? Have anybody heard about some recent announcement in social media and everybody is in that mass excitement that, you know, wow, you know, things are great and, you know, have anybody heard about some recent announcement in UK? Any one of you who have heard that things have opened up? And so those who have heard, I will give you a clarification on that as well. Okay. Unfortunately, on 12th of January, there was some announcement made by NHS and suddenly this IMG base, you know, who want to reduce the American competition, spread it a rumor that, you know, UK is the best option now and stop considering US. And but the reality is different. Okay. So I will be today talking about this recent announcement which happened in UK and what is the real picture. Does it actually change anything? Yes or no? We will be talking that as well. All right. India, of course, everybody knows the problems. I mean, competition is high. In a private college, there's a high debt and many a time preferred branches are not available. In Canada, the concern is that, of course, it's a quota system and in certain provinces, you need to know French. That's a challenge. And the entire healthcare system is a public healthcare. So unlike US and India, where you can work in private sector, grow on a faster rate, Canada is a great nation, but ultimately it's a government job. It's a great place. It's a satisfying job. It's a something long term. However, many of the people who want that adrenaline rush to, you know, succeed in life, that definitely you'll find more in US or India. Okay. Australia, again, it's a big, even a country, it's a continent. A lot of places are expensive. Lifestyle wise, there is a quota system and long the license process. Also, one feedback which I've got from my students, you know, not students, I'll say consultants. Many of you, you know, who decide to go abroad is because you don't want to work in rural India or a two-tier or a three-tier rural setup in India. But unfortunately, those who have migrated to Australia, they have migrated in such a location that it's almost underserved or with very, very, very less population. So these people again don't like, because the very reason they left India was they don't wanted to work in these underserved areas, you know. So yeah, that is something which is of concern. New Zealand, of course, it's a very small country. The population of animals is more than the humans. So that's again a challenge. Germany, of course, the proficiency of German language is very important. And finally, the Gulf countries, the challenge is the contractual jobs. You know, challenge is that you get good jobs, but those are contractual. And that's why you need to do the verifications properly. Okay. Your verification is very, very important. So make sure that you are going to do all of these things at the right time. Perfect. With this wrap of the country, let me properly give you a overall scenario of what countries and what all happens. So now, as an Indian medical student, if you want to do post-graduation, your three best options are India. So do not rule out India, US and Germany. If you already have a degree from India or America, you want to settle, you can definitely settle in Canada, Australia, New Zealand or the Middle East. And of course, US and Germany if you have PG from the respective countries. Now, I get a lot of queries where people just pick up globe and come and then tell, okay, what about Croatia? What about Caribbean? Random countries, please don't do that. I mean, it's a medical career, you require population. Otherwise, it's of no use. So high risk or improbable countries like UK, Singapore, EU. Singapore again has a list of medical colleges which are recognized. If you are a graduate from those colleges, only then you can practice. And there are only two colleges from India which are recognized. Okay, one is AIIMS Delhi and second is CMC Vellore. So if you are not from these colleges, you cannot do anything in Singapore. European Union, except for Germany, rest of all places, telcos opportunities are not that great. Population is very low. And plus, as you see the challenge in Germany, you definitely need to know local languages. And then the degree or mobility is not that great. Like English speaking countries, there are so many opportunities. You can just, you know, look off options. But when you consider Europe, you're actually stuck. That is something which you need to also keep in mind. One very, very important thing which you need to also understand is that the competition of specialties is universal. That belief that, okay, I want surgery. India mein difficult hai, but I want a guaranteed surgery in America. Nobody is going to give you a guarantee. If you know a specialization is competitive, the medical infra is similar everywhere. So if a specialty is competitive in India, it's more or less similar everywhere. So that is something which you need to understand. Broadly, if you understand the global scenario, the specialty which are comparatively easily available will be medicine, family medicine, pedia, neuro, psychiatry. Then second number comes into pathology, radio, anesthesiology. The third group, which is of competitive nature, is surgery, OBGY, emergency medicine, and very, very competitive, you know, like happens in India, ophthalmology, ENT, and dermat. So this is the reason why I've also divided this question into this lot, so that you realize that that's how the competition is also, okay? So, you know, I know of students, you know, they have not got NEET ranks in even 5 digits, okay? But they want a guaranteed surgery seat, only then they will prepare for USMLE. That's not happening, you know. So reality is, it is competition everywhere. You need to work hard, and whichever country you work hard, it will give you the result. But if you want things on a, you know, silver foil, then definitely best thing is to buy a private seat.